Hi everyone, today I'm happy to announce dynamic content, a feature that was once thought to be only for advanced WordPress users or developers, but here at Visual Composer, we've made it accessible for everyone. As you might already know, dynamic content is based on custom fields, but there are two general problems that you might face if you have decided to work with custom fields. Number one is that WordPress default fields and plugins like WooCommerce will usually have one default style or placement. To change that, you need some coding skills. And the second problem is that if you've decided to create your own custom fields, at some point, you guessed it, you will need some coding skills to actually display your fields. And I've got good news, Visual Composer can eliminate both of those problems. So let me tell you how to do exactly that with dynamic content. All right, let's start off with an example. Let's say I'm creating a blog and this is the first page with all my blog posts here. So I have my layout already, but it's just placeholders at the moment with no actual information about any posts. What I would normally do is manually copy and paste all the information about every single post here on this page, and it would take me quite a bit of time and a lot of repetitive work. I'd have to write down the title, the author, look for the picture, make the picture the same, then download the featured image, then add the featured image to this page, and that for every single post on this page. So why would I do all of this repetitive work? If there is a way to avoid that, I wouldn't. So let me show you how you can do exactly that. So here are all my posts, and let's say the first post I want to add to my page is this Being a Digital Nomad post. So as you can see, it has a title, author, and the featured image here at the bottom as well. So let's go back to our page. As you can see, each post has a set of key elements, like the featured image, the author profile picture, author name, and the post title. So in this case, all of those elements can go dynamic. And what I mean by going dynamic in this case would be that if you change any of this information in your post, it would change here on this page as well. And also you could eliminate the copy and paste process of just adding the title and author and featured image for every post. It can be automated, no way. So let's start making this page dynamic with this spot right here. And let's start with image. What makes sense in this particular page is that this would be the featured image of the post that we are writing about here. And to do that, you'll have to go to the edit window of this image. And here you see the dynamic content icon, click on it. And you can see our pop-up box here. The first thing to do is to select what kind of information we want. And here from the dropdown, of course, choose featured image. But the thing is, by default, it will take information from this current post, but that's not what we want. We want information from the Digital Nomad post. So what we would do is enable this toggle that allows us to set a custom post. So let's write down Digital Nomad, select the post and click on save. All right, and as you can see now, that's the featured image of that post. So let's continue down the element hierarchy here. So now the author profile picture, exactly the same thing. Edit, icon. Let's choose author profile picture, enable the toggle and set the same post. Save. And now, I don't know if you remember, this is the right lady. And now the same with the author name. You click on edit, then the icon and choose post author or the author name here. And again, the same post, Being a Digital Nomad, and save. All right, that's the author of the post. Now let's move on to post title, the same exact thing. Edit icon, post title, and let's set the same post. The thing about making a text block dynamic is that you can edit it right here in the editor. So as you can see, there's the default look at the moment, but we can change it to match our layout here. So it's paragraph. Let's change the font here. And the letters are bigger, 14 points. All right, now our first post is all filled out. Now when I change any of this information on that post, it will change the information here as well. Let me show you what I mean. Let's open that post here about being a digital nomad, and let's change the author, for example, to Linda. Update. And now let's take a look at that page. And the author has changed automatically. At this point, you do exactly the same thing to the rest of the post, just choosing the particular post that you're taking the information from, and that is it. And you're done. No copying and pasting. This is such a time-saving feature that gives you a chance to work on the important stuff and not give more attention to copying and pasting than you actually need. So try it out. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye.